Did you know there's a simple way to automate the deployment of your code from GitHub to Azure? Gopi is here to show us how to use GitHub Actions to deploy your solutions directly to Azure, today on Azure Friday. Hey everyone, Donovan Brown here with another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Gopi and we're going to be learning about how to use GitHub Actions to deploy to Azure. So what actually is a GitHub Action?
GitHub Actions helps you automate any workflow from developer perspective, taking your code and then creating a pull request based on the pull request, trigger an event and then do something that you want.
Okay.
Or as a new issue that got created, you want to do something with the code again.
Gotcha.
Or you know there is a label that you added to your commit, you want to do some action. So essentially, it is any workflow management
tool. Gotcha. So there's lots of different ways I can trigger one of these GitHub actions. And then there's just tasks, I assume, that you run inside your action to get things done.
Right. So those are, cool. That's what they call it as actions.
Okay.
And the cool thing is all of these actions are actually running inside a container image.
Oh, interesting. Okay, great. So where do I go to get these actions? How do I know what actions are available to me?
Right. So this is, I'm in my you know GitHub repo, and
okay.
inside the GitHub repo, you can actually see the actions that are available for me.
Okay, so this is available on anyone's GitHub repository. There's a tab for actions, and you just go in there and configure them.
Correct.
Got it.
Configure
okay.
them. So you know, here is, you know, I have my code. This is a simple application where I actually already configured it, but I'll just show you how do I edit, how do I grow up this experience.
Okay.
Like now, I just go to the main workflow. Now, if I just switch to my branch, you can actually just see that they have two ways of editing it, right?
Mm-hmm.
We see they have a visual way of editing it, the GitHub actions.
Okay.
Or you can actually edit file itself.
Okay, so this is like what, a YAML file? Or?
This is similar to YAML file, but they are using a specific format.
So it's different syntax. Got
right.
It. Okay.
Right.
Fair enough.
Right. So now I'll just go here. I already have an application. What I'm just doing is, I'm taking that application, first logging into a Docker registry, and then building the container image, tagging an image, and pushing to a container registry.
Okay.
But here is where the Azure part that comes in.
Got it.
Right? Now, the image that actually built in, I want to take that image automatically, log in into Azure, create a web app for container dynamically,
okay,
and then deploy my application. That's the workflow that is possible. So one use case that you can think of is, we are trying to do it as a push, right? As a push or as a PR, you can configure it. So as a push, you want to dynamically create an environment, deploy your application, and then test it if needed, and then destroy it once it is
got it.
I'm not coded the destroy part here, but every push, it actually takes your application automatically, is deploying it. Now you can give it for UAT testing, or you can play with your application without you doing anything.
So how did you add the task? Like, is there like a task library or something here?
Right, right. So now if I want to add a task, I just need to drag in the visual editor.
Okay.
You can see that it actually pops up the featured actions that are available. Like, they have actions available for, pretty much every cloud, AWS, Google. Now if I just search for Azure, you will find Azure clouds,
okay,
Azure tasks that are available. I can just show you, how do we use it, and then, where exactly, they are available. Now, if I add it, it just asks me for Azure. Now, I can just say perform, pretty much any AG CLI command that I want to, and I can give the argument.
I see. And
right?
That's how you added all the ones that came beforehand.
That's how I added all the ones. And the key things is, they have secrets. The secrets are, the values are not exposed. They are just stored in a strict environment where only they will be used inside the container image during the execution.
Gotcha. So above it, I see you have a deploy app to a web app. Like, can I deploy to functions and VMs and all that kind of stuff? How do
yes.
I know what right. my targets are?
So the GitHub action for Azure that I just added, let me just show you the source code. And even these actions are available. You can see the first CLI. It'll just tell you the exact usage. You can, one is, as I just shown you, you can add it through the visual editor, or you can paste this snippet into the code, that the YAML code that
okay.
is there, and then just to define the required environment variables that are needed or the secrets, then you are set. If I just bubble up to the GitHub Actions repo, you can
see
multiple actions that we have built in. For each of these, we actually have the code that is available right here. It's all about a Docker file, which Docker image that I need to use, and then what exactly needs to be done inside this.
Got it. So can you go back up one level again? So I see there's AKS in there. There's obviously the CLI. I can run an ARM template. I can do pipelines, functions, got it. Okay, so this is where, I'm assuming this is gonna continue to grow with additional targets and additional ways to deploy into GitHub, I mean, to Azure from GitHub.
Yeah, exactly. So this is actually, you know, available in the OSS, like everybody pretty much has an access. You can continue to submit PRs for, you know, every specific thing that you have. Hey, you know, I want to add a Cosmos DB deployment.
Gotcha.
I want to add a
Azure SQL
deployment. I think, you know, you can just, you know, submit the PRs. We are ready to look at it and take it forward.
Right. So we are accepting PRs for this particular repository to add additional actions to GitHub Actions.
Yes.
Awesome. Right. Well, this is really cool. It's kind of a really easy way to get started with getting your code deployed using just GitHub Actions. You don't need anything other than GitHub to get into Azure, which is really nice to know. Well, thank you so much. So we are learning all about using GitHub Actions to get to Azure here on Azure Friday.